Today I'm making a rosemary and tea tree soap bar and shampoo bar. I'm adding in my lye that I've had sitting for a couple of hours, and I'm mixing it into my oils. And the blend of oils I'm using today is canola and olive oil with some shea butter and some coconut oil. Because it's going to be a shampoo bar as well as a soap bar, I'm going to add in some castor oil. Castor oil is a heavy oil and it creates a really good lather when you use the bar on your hair. I'm just mixing it until I can see a change in the colour. It becomes a bit lighter as it emulsifies. Some essential oils, a mixture of tea tree and rosemary essential oil, and then I'll mix again and wait for the colour of the mixture to turn a lighter colour. Give it a final stir and then I'm going to split the mixture, leaving 2/3 ready to add some dried herbs and essential oils into, and I'm going to leave 1/3 of it just plain white soap batter. This is a mixture of spirulina, green oxide, and rosemary essential oil. Give it a stir, it's a beautiful green, vibrant green colour. And I'm going to add handfuls of rosemary. This was harvested from my garden, and I've dried it for a few weeks and then put it through a blender. In really well. Making soap, cold processed soap, it's really great for adding so many different herbs because it's such a high pH. It will just allow you to add all sorts of things and it will preserve them. A final mix before I'm ready to pour. I'm going to layer the soap batter, starting with the white soap batter. And then mix in some green. Hopefully it won't make a strong pattern, but there should be a nice sort of mottled pattern. Thank you. time to see what we've got. Molds I use are quite large, so I normally get about 24 bars of soap out of each mold. They're 3 kilogram molds, so I have to cut them in half first of all. Maybe not such a strong pattern I was hoping for, but they look nice and they smell nice too.